to the Thriller Villa. We are about to meet one of Disney's number one artists, Mr. Jimmy Mulligan.
All right, so for the first time ever, I'm going to show you something really spectacular at the Thriller Villa, Michael Jackson's residence. We're going to see the secret cellar where a priceless art collection was held when Michael was here before his passing. And there's a ton of really spectacular stuff, all Jimi Hendrix stuff downstairs, including secret cellars. And it's really special, so follow me. Watch your step. So, what did Michael Jackson represent? We've got this spectacular, kind of hidden archive of art. He held a priceless art collection when he was here, and now we're showcasing the artwork and the homage to Jimi Hendrix by a number of different artists. I'm introducing you now to Andrew, the man behind the mask, who actually would be a much better expert than I on the art and magic of Jimi Hendrix. Andrew.
Thank you so much. Again, my name is Andrew Pitsikalis. I'm the CEO of Rock and Artwork LLC, and welcome to the collection that we've released that is a permanent collection in Michael Jackson's Thriller Villa in Las Vegas. This was a tunnel that was Michael Jackson's that he used to hold some art, and we converted it into a beautiful gallery. This piece right here was a piece that we opened Planet Hollywood with artist David Garibaldi, which is a rhythm and hue piece that's not only signed by David, but also by Leon Hendrix, Jimi Hendrix's brother. As you look at how our collection is, we actually broke it up into various series. We have our artist rendition series, which if you see is at the beginning of our exhibition. You have a beautiful 3D piece that we did that's art of Jimi Hendrix, so it's actually art that Jimi Hendrix drew, and we did an unbelievable 3D printing job to create the depth in the piece that you have here. We also did a dedication to the halo piece, which was a Hendrix, was one of the first photos that was done by Hendrix's photographer, Carl Ferris, in London. And then Justin Farina, who is a famous sports illustrating artist, did a rendition in oil of Jimmy. Then we also have our pieces here, which is our space series, which is done by Dan Kennedy, one of our artists that we have hired, to do a whole series of what he felt it would be like if Jimi Hendrix had the ability to jam in space. So each one of our pieces, you have Jimmy, which is called the Outer Session, is on Mars, then Saturn, Pluto, and then on the moon, where he's kind of jamming with the Earth in the background, which is a really cool piece. And then as you continue on, we will show you, we have some originals that are really cool. What we have here is our artist photography series, where I selected 10 of my favorite photos that we have color enhanced and digitalized. And you have Boston Gardens, Framingham, Massachusetts, again another Boston Gardens piece, Woodstock. Right at the end of Woodstock, Jimmy put the peace and love symbol, which is one of my favorite pieces. We had taken a pole out of the Hendrix part here and then added the clouds for effect. This is another rendition also of that series. And then as you come around here, you have some of Jimmy's album covers. And then you also have, if you come over here, are pieces that are done by the number one printer in the world. These pieces were flown in from Moscow. And what's interesting about these pieces is that if you can see, and you might not be able to see as much with the camera, that there's almost a metallic grade that's in the areas of the shirt. And even if you look at in this piece, metallic layers that are laid on top of it, and it's actually a very interesting screen printing process, and you need a press that almost costs over $150,000 to be able to produce the pieces that you see on this back wall. You also have here the art by Jimi Hendrix. These are pieces that Jimi Hendrix actually drew himself in the last few years of his life. All of these pieces represent pieces that Jimmy drew with colored markers. And if you look also down the hall, we have the Renaissance of Jimmy. These pieces are called the Renaissance of Jimmy. These were at the younger stages of early 20s of Jimmy's life. And these pieces all represent stuff that was symbolic to Jimmy and is a very cool collection, one of my favorites. So here you have, hidden in this unbelievable tunnel, and you ask yourself why. You know, why is this Hendrix stuff down here? Why is this hidden in this tunnel? Because Michael Jackson had hidden over $650 million of created art in this tunnel when he lived into this house. And when they took the art out of it, it was thought to be, well, what a great idea it would be to take this tunnel and turn it into an art gallery, and then also, you know, display different pieces of art from different artists. And originally that was the first idea, and then they approached me and we started talking about these two iconic legends and what a great combination it would be for both of them to be represented here and to actually take, which was a very drab tunnel, and turn it into a beautiful gallery that is now the home of this wonderful Hendrix collection that we are displaying today and also going to be distributing worldwide to the 2 billion fans that Jimmy has. So thank you so much for coming and looking at our collection, and you know, hopefully soon you'll see it in galleries all over the world.